I don't know about you guys, but my long-term portfolio is completely destroyed. I've not sold anything, indeed, have started to nibble in with new money in addition to my monthly contribution. I think it's time to reassess our portfolios and look at stocks that should be added given this massive opportunity. Let's talk about it. What's happening, everyone? Welcome to Think Finance. My name is Raj, and on this channel, I talk about personal finance, investment ideas, money management tips, and all things finance. If you're new to the channel and money gets you going, consider subscribing. In this video, I want to share my watch list, 50 stocks I'm considering to invest in given this crazy sell-off and with recession on deck. Finally, there are a few stocks I've already decided to buy, so we'll give you a snapshot of changes I've made to my portfolio. If you've been following this channel, you know I use M1 Finance to manage my long-term portfolio. It's a mix of leverage ETFs and individual stock names. Today, I'm gonna focus on stocks only. I'm working on a separate video on what I'm doing with leverage ETFs, so do subscribe and hit the notification bell to get notified. When it comes to stocks, I have a few ground rules. Number one, it is a dividend growth stock. I strongly believe in the power of compounding, and dividend is a big part of my strategy. Only exception to this rule is some of the big names like Amazon, Google, and few others. Number two, it has a strong history in terms of management execution, earnings, and revenue. Number three, it has a history of consistently beating the S&P 500 year over year. I have a separate video on my investment strategy. Link will be on the screen. Before we get into actual stocks, let me give you my thought process. During downturns, there are certain sectors that weather the storm better than others. Healthcare, utility, consumer staples, telecommunications, and defense are considered defensive compared to sectors that are more cyclical in nature, like retailers, consumer technology, restaurants, home builders, automobiles, and travel. In this pandemic hit economy or work from home economy, here are some of the trends I'm seeing. People are working from home using collaboration tools like Zoom Video and Microsoft Teams and other online training tools, spending more time on streaming services like Netflix and Amazon Prime, demanding more daily use items like toilet paper and toothpaste, using more utilities like electricity and water, and investing in more defensive stocks like consumer staples, hoping to get less impacted by the downturn. So here is how I'm gonna break the stocks down. Cloud services and technology stocks, consumer staples and defensive stocks, healthcare, utilities, telecommunications, streaming services, automobile parts distributors, discount retailers, military and defense. And then just beaten down sectors like financials, semis, materials, and travel. Let's talk about cloud services and technology. Think cloud service providers and collaboration tools. Demand for these services is only going to go up. In a work from home economy, companies have realized the value of cloud and other supporting technologies. Here I have Microsoft, Google, Apple, Adobe, Amazon, Zoom Video, Spotify, Okta, Facebook, and Keg. These guys are into on-demand training. Amazon is also going to benefit from its retail business. No one is going out. Let's order from Amazon, right? Consumer staples and defensive stocks. Flight to safety. Usually, these fare better in a recession as they are considered defensive. On this list, I have Procter & Gamble, Clorox, Kellogg's, Kroger, and Colgate. I have also included Home Depot, Costco, Walmart, and McDonald's in this category. Automobile parts distributors. See, people are not going to buy new cars. Yes, interest rates are low, and deals will be out there. But we are also going to hit a recession. People may lose jobs. The fear is going to force most of us to keep our existing cars longer. And these cars are going to need parts to keep them going. I'm watching O'Reilly and AutoZone here, discount retailers. As economy takes a toll on jobs and income, people are going to look for value and deals. Stores like Ross and Dollar Tree can potentially thrive here. I'm also including Target in this category, which has done fairly well compared to the rest of the market. Healthcare, considered a safer sector in a downturn. Some of the names I have here are also involved in developing a vaccine for COVID-19. Johnson & Johnson, can't go wrong with that. Abbott, Gilead, Moderna, and Regeneron. Streaming services. People are home and they are going to stay home and they will stream. No brainer. Stay at home stocks. Netflix, Disney, and Roku. Of course, Disney is more than just streaming. Utilities. Again, people are home. They will use more gas, electricity, and water. To be honest, home or no home, people don't cut down on utilities. This sector traditionally is a steady performer. With recession on deck, this might be a place to hide. Options here are waste management, One Gas, and Next Era Energy. Telecommunications. Recession, bear market, or tsunami, most people don't cut down on telecommunication services like phones and internet. Also, these have been beaten down big and dividend yields are really tempting. I'm talking about AT&T and Verizon. Military and defense. Typically, military and defense related names do well during downturns. I'm only tracking one name here, Lockheed Martin. Comes with a hefty dividend as well. Finally, some sectors have been impacted the most. In a low interest rate environment, financials have gotten killed. COVID-19 has brought a stop on travel. Airline and cruise line stocks have fallen almost 50 to 60%. Don't buy these for dividend only. I know it's tempting, but some have started to cut or suspend dividend, so be aware of that. Other sectors impacted the most include semiconductors and materials. For financials, I'm watching JP Morgan and Citibank, Delta and Carnival Cruise for travel. Bunch of names for semis, including my fave Nvidia and Taiwan Semi. And finally, Sherwin-Williams under materials. So that is what I'm watching. Most of these offer a decent dividend and are considered leaders in what they do. I'm still doing my research, but there are some that have made into my portfolio. Here is a list of everything I'm currently invested in. I recently added Amazon, Adobe, NextEra Energy, and Visa. Okay, that's all I have, guys. I wanted to use this video to share what I'm thinking, but more importantly, get feedback from you guys. What's on your shopping list? Let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching. If this was helpful, hit that like button. And if money gets you going, consider subscribing. Until next time, peace.